And welcome to another studio vlog. So super exciting news, lots of new goodies have arrived in the studio. I freaking love the feeling of opening a new product and seeing how it has come into fruition and how it's like come into a physical object in my hand. It literally gets me so freaking excited. And we have some washi tapes, so I thought we would do a little unboxing together. And the memo pads have also just arrived. So yesterday I actually filmed like a little cute reel for Instagram and TikTok, and I was super happy with how the memo pads turned out. I photographed them and I got them all up on the shop yesterday, and today I'm finally going to unbox the washi tapes. I've literally been waiting so long to do this because I like to do it on the studio vlog, but last week it kind of ran over a little bit, and I also am not going to release these washi tapes just yet. I'm going to release them when the wax melts get launched, which hopefully, fingers crossed, will be this Sunday. So yesterday was a complete write-off of a day. We spent the majority of the day trying to sort out business insurance for these wax melts, and we still didn't get any further because a lot of our sales are to the US, like 40% of our sales are to the US, and a lot of insurance companies just will not take us on because it's a class as a high sue country, I think, I don't know. Anyway, it's been a freaking nightmare trying to sort insurance out, so we're going to do that again today. So I'm going to show you the washi tapes now because I was planning on doing it yesterday, so let's just get into the washi tapes and then I'm going to get to work on some other stuff and hopefully nail decals. I also have a nail appointment because my nails are so scabby. But yeah, let's just get into the working day, shall we? Fingers crossed it's gonna be a better day today.
First one we've got, oh, look at these goodies.
Oh my gosh. We have Pudding the dog on top. Oh, look at this. I love the new labels. I tried something different with the labels, and rather than the generic Katnipp logo, I decided to go with the characters that were featured on the washi tape and the design. So let's open these up. We have the gingy and spice ones, and we have the bumble butt ones, so the bee ones. So I've actually redesigned the bee. I had a bee washi tape before, but I've updated it a little bit. So let's have a look what they turned out like. I'm so excited. So the first one is this gingy and spice in Candy Cane Lane. Oh. Yay. Okay, so these are the new washi tapes and they've turned out so freaking cute. So first of all, we've got this little pudding, Christmas pudding, and the foil looks so pretty. I don't know if you can see, but it's a gold foil. You can see a little bit in this section here. And then this is the roll. I thought I'd do it on a white background so you guys could see a little better. Then we've got the frog on bear. Now this is the only one that I didn't get foiled this time. And that's what the frog on bear one looks like. Little frogs and little rain clouds. Then we got the bee ones, which I am super happy with. That has turned out so cute. And we've got these little flower pollens kind of floating around. And they again are in gold, as you can see here. And then finally, we've got Ginger and Spice in Candy Cane Lane for the Christmas one. And I decided to do a white background on this, so it's kind of like snowy. And we've got like red accents and again, gold foils. So this is the four new washi tapes. How freaking exciting is that? And I'm really, really happy with how they've turned out. Like the front logo looks so cute on them. Literally can't wait to use this in the planner. Also, this one was misprinted, so I'm going to keep this for myself and I'm going to do Christmas gifts with it. Around and Dean's put my big chunky hoodie on. Cool. You can't be there, Dean. Oh, you're like a big squishy bear. Let me cuddle you. And happy Saturday. So we're gonna work the weekend this weekend because there is a lot that I need to do, and I actually haven't vlogged for about 2 days. I filmed an exclusive Patreon vlog yesterday where I showed a new member of the Katnipp team, aka the iMac that I've got sat next to me. I ended up investing in another Mac for this room because what was happening was I initially used to use the big Mac, which is behind me, what Dean's on right now, as my editing Mac. And since Mike and Dean work here, that became what we call the main Mac in the studio, and what Dean and Mike kind of uses on a daily basis to open all the Photoshop files and print them off. And it's kind of like the hub of the office where everything gets printed off from. So then I kind of got pushed away into a little corner to edit, and I was using my MacBook, which was originally for home so I could do work at home, and it just was so slow, and it was really slowing me down, and it was taking me a long time to edit the footage because I film in 4K and I also edit and export in 4K. And although it is the MacBook Pro, it still ended up running out of memory. The scratch discs would get full very quickly, so I decided it was time to bite the bullet and finally purchase this iMac. So I did a little unboxing on the exclusive Patreon video if you want to go check it out. There's exclusive videos every month over on Patreon, so I'll leave a link in the description below. But yeah, today I'm actually going to experiment with some new nail decals. So if you have been around for a while, you you would know, this time last year I brought out my first set of nail decals, but if I'm being completely honest, I wasn't really happy with the results because I had to print it on an inkjet printer, seal it with some varnish, and it was just a very long process and I felt like it wasn't really very professional. It kind of still had that handmade quality. I never had really a bad review about them and they worked really nicely, but I thought the process was a little tedious, so I ended up investing in a laser printer. So we're going to set that up today and we're going to have a go at nail decals. But first of all, I'm going to eat my jack of potato. We went and got some lunch and got a jack of potato for lunch, so I'm going to eat this and then I'm going to get to work on nail decals. So let's get into it, shall we? Test print. I printed it on a piece of plain paper. I actually wasn't meant to be a test print, but it's getting ready for Cricket and I like the size of the decals and the print quality is nice for laser too, so happy with this. Now I'm just going to try and set it up to print out on the laser, the waterside paper. Yay! Yay, it's so much better quality. Oh my gosh. Now it's time to cut this on the Cricut and do a little experiment and make sure that these hold up and are waterproof.
Wow, it's literally got no stick to it at all.
Okay, so I've just finished cutting the nail decals and they have turned out so cute. You get lots more per pack than my original ones. This is what I did for my original ones. As you can see, the sticker sheet size, the nail decal size should I say, is a lot bigger, and we're going to slide it in these bags, but I think I might have made them a little big. I'm not sure if they're going to fit into these size cellos. I'm hoping they're going to. I'm not sure. I'm also not sure what I'm going to do with the backing cards. This is what they turned out like. What do you think? I think they're really, really cute. So I'm going to experiment with these and see if they work, first of all. Okay, I haven't got much to work with. I've got a huge pair of scissors. None of my nail stuff is in the studio. I've also got a Posca pen. I don't know if this is actually going to work, but I have seen some people use nail varnish underneath if they want to keep the whites of the decals, because these are actually transparent when you take them off the sheet ready for the nails, and my nails are pretty dark, so I'm just going to apply it to the top. You meant to seal it with a top coat, but I'm so impatient. I just want to make sure that they're waterproof, so I'm just going to do a daft experiment and then I'll probably have to bring my nail stuff into the studio. I don't know which one I want to use. I think a little pumpkin guy, a little candy corn would be cute. Oh, these scissors are so big. I need like little nail scissors. So I'm going to dip this in the water. I've just got a shallow bowl of water and hope for the best. Seems like no ink's coming off, so that's a good sign. Let's try and slide it off. I've slid a little bit off. So that's a good sign. At least we know it's waterproof. So as you can see, it's actually transparent. And if I put it on my nail that's dark, you won't be able to see the colours as much. Just a little random guy just on the table, little candy corn guy, but that's what it looks like on the table. So if you had a white nail, it would look like that. But I want to try use a Posca pen underneath. I haven't got tweezers, I don't know how this is going to turn out, but let's just try it. So you would get the nail varnish and you would add white underneath the picture if you wanted to put it on a dark coloured nail. So I'm just using a Posca pen because that's all I've got right now. Okay, I've just smudged it.
everywhere, so it's not working. I'm gonna have to wait until I bring my nail stuff in tomorrow to give it a good try, but it's nice to know that it's waterproof and it works.
Just out of curiosity, I wanted to see if it would transfer on my skin as a temporary tattoo, and it's worked. So let me know in the comments if you would like to see me bring out a temporary tattoo range. I hope this doesn't stay on for too long. Oh no, I'm gonna have little candy corns stuck on the center of my palm.
Good morning, guys. Happy Monday. So yesterday I had the day off and I literally did nothing all day apart from play Animal Crossing, and it was the best time ever. I'm totally back into it. I had like a huge gap when I was moving into the studio of not playing, and now like I'm back into it and all the Halloween stuff is all over my island. Absolutely love it. So I'm feeling refreshed for this Monday, and I'm going to get to work on doing the nail decals just to make sure that they look nice with the top coat on. My nail lady is actually on this floor in the building. She moved in, she's called Kate. She moved into this building when we did. So I've actually asked her if she's got like a spare like nail thing. I had them somewhere, but I can't seem to find them. And then also I thought it would be a good idea to pay her to maybe design some using my nail decals, and also get her honest opinion on the nail decals and make sure that they're good quality. Because obviously she is a nail lady and she knows what she's looking for in products like nail decals. She's worked with a lot of them, so her opinion actually means a lot, and to get her honest feedback about them would be great. So I'm going to get to work on doing that. I'm going to do some emails and everything first and make a coffee, and then try out the new nail decals. I'm pretty sure they're going to work. They worked the other day, it's just I didn't really have the right tools. So yeah, let's get into the working day, shall we? Added a little star to the little candy cane. Okay, so I've laid out the little nail decals on a nail like this. It's looking pretty cute. I'm just gonna now seal it with this no wipe UV top coat. I got this off like eBay. I've actually just contacted Kate and she's took a pack and she's gonna experiment with them as well and make sure she likes them. But I'm really happy with them. They look so much better than how I used to make them. They look so much bolder. I'm gonna seal them with this and then see what the finished piece looks like. Okay, so this is the finished piece. I am so freaking happy with how these have turned out. They are so much better than my old ones. So I'll probably be selling my old ones off as seconds for a very low price. But look, I don't know if you can see if the camera's gonna pick this up, but how cute did it turn out? So I added some little stars and everything from the pack to create this little nail and painted it white. Now, like I said, you can paint the underneath of the illustrations white if you want to put it on a darker color. So you'd have to paint the underneath and then stick it down if you wanted the white to come through on a dark background. But look at this. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. I can't wait to see what Kate does with her nails as well, but super, super happy with how this has turned out. So I've used a gel top coat, but you don't need to use a gel top coat. You can use like a normal top coat to seal it in, but obviously a gel top coat lasts a much longer time. And then I bought this like cheap lamp off Argos, but you can buy them on Amazon, and this is a no wipe top coat, super cheap, but it just helps seal it in for much longer and stays on your nail for a lot longer. The only thing is you have to soak them off. But you could also take this, if you get your nails done properly, you could buy it and take it to your nail technician, because that is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take these and get my nails done, because I get my nails done by Kate, and she's going to put these on for me, but she's also going to try them out with her clients too. So how cute does that look?
Mike wanted one of his nails doing as a little skull, so I've done this little skull on his nail. What do you think, Mike? Do you think it's cute?
It's adorable.
I really, really loved having the old nail decals, but I felt like the inkjet printer was not right for the product. And I always want to make my products as best as they can be. And I actually wore a bunch of my own nail decals over the months. And when I went to Disney World, I was swimming underwater a lot. And I found that two of the decals on my nails actually bled a little, even though I sealed them in. So I kind of put off releasing any new nail decals until I found a method and a product that worked for me. So I was going to source them outside of the business, but I wanted to keep them in-house for now, so I had control of the quality. And now I'm finally happy with how the product has turned out. It's super nice, super crisp as well, the illustrations, and doesn't bleed whatsoever. The paper is also much thicker, so it's much more pliable, whereas the paper I was using before wasn't as pliable, and it was very, very papery thin and used to rip quite easy. So I'm super, super happy. It means I can bring out a ton of different nail decals now, which is what I've wanted to do for the longest time, because I absolutely love getting my nails done, and I just think it'd be really cute to like kind of wear my characters out and about. The next nail decals I'm going to do are Frog and Bear. I'm going to recreate the Christmas collection that I had last year, and yeah, hopefully relaunch them. So I'm actually going to design the backing cards, and I think I'm actually going to get them manufactured and then brought in so that I could double side it with the instructions on the back and then the backing card on the front. So probably in the next studio vlog you'll see that, but for now I think I'm going to end the studio vlog here. So question of the week this week is, if you could see any nail decal characters from my store, what would it be? Or characters you would like to see, like say a lemon or ginger or spice, let me know in the comments below and I'll totally take it on board and do some of them. So I hope you enjoyed the studio vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Alright then, thank you so much for watching. I love you. Goodbye.